got me into the gown, and as I'm laying down on the machine where they, you know, slide the tray into the big donut thing that makes all the noise, the tech says to me, okay, now we're going to start an IV drip with some gadolinium agent in it for contrast. And I was shocked because I did not know that contrast was going to be involved in this scan, and I'm now alarmed anytime you want to give me something through a needle. Well, what the heck is that?
Especially if it's metal.
Right, and in this case, it's metal. It's gadolinium, which I know nothing about. But what I do know is that if you chase down the supposedly safe and effective adjuvants that are used in vaccines, that they turn out to be not at all safe and over-effective. All right, they trigger your immune system to freak out over all kinds of stuff it shouldn't, and they stay in the body, and the body has no way of excreting them because it doesn't have any evolutionary experience with this sort of thing. So I became alarmed. I did not sit up because I was, in fact, not able to, but...
You already strapped down?
I think I wasn't exactly strapped down, but I was in a position where that would have been disruptive.
Yeah.
And so I said, well, tell me about this contrast agent, and she didn't... It has an acronym that I've forgotten. But anyway, what I found out from her was that it is primarily...
She went and talked to the radiologist.
Not yet.
Okay.
It's primarily made of gadolinium, which is a rare earth element, and that it does exactly what you would expect it to do, which is it allows you to see things in a scan which are difficult to see otherwise. And I said... Is it necessary to the scan? She said, you can decline it, though I got the impression that no one ever does.
But also, that's not an answer.
Right.
Is it necessary? You can decline it. Well, if by declining it, I render the scan useless, then I have to make a different decision.
Which is exactly...
Do I or do not get the scan?
Which is exactly what I said to her. And she said, I could call the radiologist. And I said, would you? So she stepped out of the room. I was able to hear her conversation or her side of the conversation with the radiologist. And she came back and she said, it's very useful, but it's not required. And I said, the scan will still have value without it. And she said, yes. And so anyway, I declined this, this contrast agent. Mm-hmm. Then after the scan, in the dressing room, I discovered that there was a sheet that actually talks about the contrast agent. Jen, do you have an image of the sheet?
And you had theoretical access to this in advance, but you hadn't been told
but
you
were doing it. Yeah, which, you know, could just be an oversight. So anyway.
As part of your examination, the radiologist may deem it advisable to give you an IV injection of a contrast agent containing gadolinium. This injection may help the physician more accurately diagnose your condition. Although these contrast agents have been used safely in millions of cases, minor reactions, principally headache or nausea, do rarely occur, and serious or life-threatening reactions have been reported. A rare but serious complication known as NSF. Oh no.
Known to the NSF as NSF.
A rare but serious complication known as NSF has been reported when gadolinium is administered to patients on dialysis who have severe kidney failure.
Okay. So this, after the scan was already over and I had declined the agent, led me down a path where I started looking into various aspects of this. At first, I was concerned that gadolinium might cross the blood-brain barrier and end up in the brain. I was also concerned that the body might have no way of excreting it, just the same way that aluminum accumulates, because the body doesn't have a mechanism for dealing with it. There's initially a whole layer of material that suggests that, in fact, it doesn't cross the blood-brain barrier if the blood-brain barrier is intact. And that it is excreted by the body, you know, almost all of it is gone within 24 hours. So that's very comforting. It doesn't necessarily make it safe that it was coursing through your veins, which is in fact what it would be doing in this case. It's not even an intramuscular injection. It's, you know, it's an IV.
Also, on what basis should we assume that anyone has a fully intact blood-brain barrier at this point?
100%. So I started looking into things that are known to damage the blood-brain barrier, and they're all... list of things that are commonly encountered. Right. For example, Glyphosate damages the blood-brain barrier. Glyphosate, which is apparently found in every single California wine, including organic wines, apparently having, you know, leaked through the environment. BPA, a common ingredient in plastics that is often in contact with food, damages the blood-brain barrier. Alcohol damages the blood-brain barrier. So the idea that it doesn't cross the blood-brain barrier if it's intact should give you no comfort whatsoever. Mm-hmm. In addition, if you dig far enough, you discover that autopsy studies have found that there is often gadolinium trapped in the brain after years since a scan. Now, this is attributed...
So in gadolinium, the tiny bit that I looked into is basically only in human endeavors, this is the thing it is used for.
Yeah.
So if in autopsies, gadolinium is being found in humans, it is from this contrast dye used for MRIs.
Exactly. So to put a little more color on that, gadolinium is used for MRI studies specifically because it has highly unusual electromagnetic properties, something, I think it has 7 free electrons. And so
under different conditions, it's differently magnetic.
It's very attracted to magnetic fields. And so, of course, the MRI is entirely, I mean, the MRI is a frickin' miracle of a device. What it does by, you know, exciting these electromagnetically charged particles, it allows you to see internally to basically, you know, thin slice an organ or a part of a person.
And it's totally safe.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if it's totally safe,
no,
but
not.
At least...
We know it's not totally... It's, you know, you don't want to just on a whim get an MRI any more than on a whim you want to get an X-ray.
Well, let's put it this way. I don't know that the magnetism is destructive. I will not be at all surprised to discover that it is, but I don't know that the magnetism is itself destructive. I would imagine there's a whole lot of radiation in these scans. It's not X-ray radiation, so it's not as bad as a CAT scan, but nonetheless, I'm sure there's a cost to be paid for MRIs, but nonetheless, this particular element is used because it has this very unusual electron configuration that causes it to be very reactive to the fields that are generated by this device. It is in fact toxic, highly toxic.
Gadolinium.
Yes, gadolinium is
gadolinium.
It is highly toxic in its elemental form, so it is bound to a ligand to cause it to be non-toxic, which raises a question about how well
it
is bound.
Stay bound.
Right, how long does it stay bound? There's certainly some conditions in which it becomes unbound. So anyway, the answer is, I'm not saying that this contrast agent isn't safe enough to use. Well, no. I think I am saying it's not safe enough to use. I'm not saying it is so harmful that it is not justified. Mm-hmm. I am saying that what we have is the same pattern that we have seen in so many places now, where there is a layer of literature that will lead you into complacency, and then there is another layer of literature that will lead you into alarm if you ever discover it, because you will find out this is unnatural, persistent, toxic, that other features of our novel environment cause it to be more dangerous than that initial layer of literature would lead you to imagine. And so, of course, the upshot of the entire story is that this is the place where informed consent plus liability is the key. Mm-hmm. Now, in this case, let me say this carefully. I do not bear any ill will to the people in this imaging center. I do believe that I was due a warning. Hey, we're planning to give you an IV of this stuff. You should look into it before you come. If you decline it, it will reduce the quality of the scan by blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. But it is not required, instead of the sort of momentum that there was to giving me this thing. Now, I understand why the momentum is there. I'm guessing that you either come in with a kidney issue that will cause your doctor to flag this as don't give them the agent because it causes serious side effects. But that short of that, people just go along with it, not knowing what I now, you know as a sadder but wiser, you know, post-COVID biologist who has learned about metals and their various medical uses and the horrifying consequences of them. So, you know, I did have the sense that I dodged a bullet, right? I was able to, you know, if I had been just not really paying attention, you know, okay, we're going to give you an IV. If, you know, it could easily have been done, and I would greatly regret it.